So we got a new update today for Vanguard, Warzone, and even a little bit of Black Ops Cold War. But the big focus here of this was the brand new Secrets of the Pacific event coming within Vanguard and Warzone. But we also got a handful of other things that are definitely worth noting with today's update. So that said, we're gonna break down everything that changed here in this video. So as we go along, let me know your thoughts down below. How you guys liking the Secrets of the Pacific event so far? Is there anything particular you're hoping to see in the near future? Whatever the case, drop it down in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, do me a favor, drop a like on the video. Let's aim for 2,000 likes on this. You guys have been crushing it here in terms of the support, so truly thank you guys so much for that. It means the world to me. And of course, if you guys are new to the channel and want to stay up to date with all things Vanguard, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a single thing. We have so much coming up on deck with season one for Warzone and Vanguard right around the corner. So if you're part of that nearly 70% of viewers that are not subscribed, if you'd like to stay up to date with everything, I'd love to have you in the community. That said, let's jump right into what changed. So part two of the three-part series in which Warzone is going to be transitioning into Warzone Pacific, the brand new experience here coming within season one of Vanguard and Warzone has kicked off today. We're going to start there with this video talking about the Secrets of the Pacific event here. When you boot up either Warzone or Vanguard, you'll be met with a Secrets of the Pacific event sort of title card in which it shows a little bit of information, a blast from the past, challenges and rewards, and a new blueprint reward on offer at the end of all of it, where it says you can scout Verdansk to find objects from another era and unlock a preview of your next destination. Also stating that you can complete challenges in Vanguard and Warzone to unlock exclusive rewards, and completing either the Vanguard or Warzone set of challenges can unlock an exclusive event weapon blueprint. So that's something that gives us that brief overview, but whenever you actually go into the game, you'll see that there is a brand new tab for, again, either Warzone or Vanguard of the Secrets of the Pacific. This lasting for another 13 days and a couple of hours in change, hinting at the season one update being overnight as we've seen in recent seasonal updates, but don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves here. Just like the Haunting event, the Numbers, the Groundfall, events like all of that, it comes with its own event tab and challenges associated within Warzone and Vanguard. Now, for the Warzone specific challenges, unfortunately, all of these have to be done within BR, the Battle Royale mode here. You can't do this in Plunder or Payload or anything like that. You have to go into Battle Royale because the challenges that you end up sort of getting inside the game are associated with surviving waves and or winning matches depending on when you pick them up. So it is something that requires that Battle Royale aspect of it. But for these challenges, again, all of these in relation to Battle Royale and going and searching out specific locations shown in photographs on the menu, but those locations being the prison showers, the electronics store in Promenade West, Burger Town at the airport, hospital, the newly opened up mines beneath old mines west of airport's tarmac, and then the World War II bunkers. After you find the actual item you're looking for, if you guys remember the intel missions from Modern Warfare, it'll follow very similarly here to that. You can go and collect that intel once you find the interactable item. That's when you'll be tasked with either surviving one wave or winning the game for those that find it much later on in the match. Once you do though, once you complete that wave or you end up winning the match, you'll then complete the challenge and it's tracked. So in theory, you can hit all of these seemingly in one game. You're probably not going to though. And truth be told, I think the Vanguard's method is actually a lot easier. For that, the Vanguard challenges only task you with getting 25 eliminations, 5 multi-kills, performing one finishing move, voting for a team MVP in 10 different matches, playing matches with another member on your clan 5 times, and getting only 3 wins. So when you think about it, half of those matches can be done within one single match with, say, Ship House returning this week for shipment and DOS House. So you can knock out a lot of those a lot easier. And of course, maybe just in terms of overall timing, it may take a little bit, but will probably be a little bit less stressful. Now, completing either category of all 6 challenges for either Warzone or Vanguard will net you an exclusive reward blueprint as always. Though there is kind of a catch or two here at this. Number one, it's not able to be previewed just yet in the event menu, so you can't see exactly what you get from the Warzone side of things. And also, the blueprint itself, even if you do complete it, it's not live until Warzone and Vanguard season 1, so in just under 2 weeks time at this point. Now, coming back to that preview thing, if you do want to see what this looks like beforehand, you can actually check this out in the Vanguard Armory. It's the Bomber Menace blueprint for the STG-44, which comes along with the Scythe Compensator, Krosnack 620mm Precision Barrel, the Mark 18 Sun Filter, the Konstanz Tactical Stock, the M1941 Handstop, the 8mm Kurz 45 Round Drum Mag, the Rubber Grip, and Vital. All in all, it's actually not that bad of a build for a weapon, and also for something you get for just simply participating in going around either Vanguard or Warzone doing some arbitrary things. It's not half bad either for a free blueprint. Now, additionally, talking about Warzone and the map updates and the overall sort of event itself, the first thing you'll notice whenever you jump into a battle royale match here is that you're met with a new sort of startup screen before dropping into the pregame lobby. It ends up mentioning, at least as of today, Warzone T-minus 13 days until we leave Verdansk, seemingly being updated with every day leading up until the season 1 launch of Warzone Pacific and the brand new map of Caldera. So that's something that if you want to get your final last reps in on Verdansk, now's the time to do it because we are running out of time. Now, also, we did see that, of course, those mines were opened up as a part of that challenge set for Secrets of the Pacific, and if I'm totally honest with you, man, a little bit bummed out about this. It's cool that we finally get to see this introduced, but I mean, this was a part of the initial TAC map atlas, the official guide for Verdansk 84, all the way back when this was introduced in March and April. So we've now waited 6-7 months to see a small part of the map that honestly could have been really cool to see introduced from the very beginning, teased that entire time and just opened up for the last 13 days of almost an entire year of playing on this map. So a little bum that we didn't get that opened up sooner, but alas, we do have it opened up now. But that's the Secrets of the Pacific event that is happening within Warzone and Vanguard respectively, but there also was a little bit more in terms of today's update that you can actually go in and take a look at. Of course, we do have our playlist updates as we normally see, with Vanguard starting out with Doorbuster Blitz, which is blitz pacing for respawn modes on described as urban maps, Trip Defend Tactical, which is tactical TDM on larger maps, which also do appreciate that Thanksgiving related naming pun, the Small Map Mayhem, which is blitz and assault pacing for TDM and domination on small maps, Ship House 24/7, which is shipment and DOS house all the time, Rocket Hill Duos, which is Champion Hill but with rocket gun sets, which is interesting, and Champion Hill regular duos are on offer this week, along with your regular modes that you can get in terms of the quick play filter. Now, unfortunately, you can't get these featured playlists in the hardcore subset of Vanguard just yet, which hopefully we see that fixed out in the near future. But jumping over to the Warzone side of things in terms of the update for the playlist, we have Operation Flashback still continuing, so if you guys want to play around with that older ground loot, those in-game events happening every single circle, and also the ability to earn a little bit of exclusive rewards in terms of an emblem and a calling card for winning one of those matches, you still can. Plunder Trios is making a return, Rebirth Resurgence Quad sticks around, Payload makes a return, and of course we have solos, duos, trios, and quads for your traditional battle royale. Now, if that's not enough, of course, for those that are still grinding out Vanguard, we do have double XP, double weapon XP, and double battle pass XP available for not only Vanguard, but also Warzone, and also Black Ops Cold War for those that are still playing here with that haven't quite made the jump to Vanguard or maybe don't want to. So a little bit of everything for everyone, which is awesome to see. But in terms of other things coming, that's really about it. It doesn't seem like we've had any technical changes just yet, and I don't believe that we will have any just yet. Sledge is now on holiday for Thanksgiving here in the States, and they even put out a message on their Twitter today mentioning that. So they'll be back in the office doing hopefully all they can to work on the game still this coming Monday and beyond. But for right now, it is a little bit of that holiday weekend, so might be a little bit of a slower turn going into this next coming days, but you have some double XP to grind out and things like that. So that said, that is the update and everything we got across Vanguard, Warzone, and even a little bit of Black Ops Cold War as of today. So let me know your thoughts down below. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video though. If you did, make sure you drop a like down below. And of course, if you are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a single thing regarding all things Vanguard, Warzone, and anything COD related. With season 1 right around the corner, we are going to have so much you do not want to miss. So make sure you stick it here on the channel. If you'd like to follow me over on Twitter and Instagram as well, those are the best place to chat with me outside of YouTube. Those links can be found in the description below. But that said, that's what we're going to call it. So thanks so much for watching. My name is Espresso. I'll see you guys later. Take care and peace.